There are several ways of calculating solution concentration. The two that we're most interested in are percent and molarity. And we have formulas for both of these. Just in general terms, percent is equal to the part over the total times 100. Usually this is a smaller number. The total is the larger number. In more precise terms, for the solution chapter, percent is equal to the amount of solute over the amount of solution times 100. Molarity has a formula. It's moles of solute over liters of solution. Let's work a problem with molarity. What is the concentration of a sodium chloride solution when 0.40 moles of sodium chloride is dissolved in water to give 2.00 liters of solution? Well, if I encountered this on an exam, I'd say to myself, well, I see lots of numbers. Chances are it's a math problem. Do I have a formula for it? Yes, we do. I see the key words in here of concentration and solution, and so I'd jot down the formula for molarity. Molarity is moles over liters. And then this formula is like a roadmap for us. All we really need to do is substitute in. Up here would go the concentration of the moles of sodium chloride, down below the volume of the solution. And if we divide, we get 0.20 moles per liter, or in other words, 0.20 M. Let's work a little harder problem this time, and instead of being given moles, we'll start with grams. That's a little more realistic, because if you were going into the laboratory, you'd work with grams rather than moles. And to make it one step harder here, let's work with milliliters rather than liters. What is the molarity when 3 grams of sodium chloride is dissolved in enough water to give 100 milliliters of solution? Well, molarity is mentioned. We've got a formula for molarity, moles of solute over liters of solution. We could convert grams of sodium chloride into moles. We could convert milliliters into liters and then simply divide, and we'd have molarity. There's another way, though, that I'd like you to think of working this problem. Whichever one works the best for you is fine with me. This one we'd work in 2 steps, but we can also work the problem using the factor unit method. And if this is easier, I would advise you to use it. Let's look at the factor unit method. In the factor unit method, you know there are 3 steps. In the first step, we'd write down the numbers that are given and the units. And this time I've arranged what we've been given in fractional form, because what we're after is also in fractional form. We're after moles per liter, or in other words, molarity. So I've put that over there on the right-hand side. And now coming back and thinking about the factors that we need to solve this problem, if I could convert grams of sodium chloride into moles of sodium chloride, and then in the next factor, convert milliliters into liters, we'd have the units that we're after. In other words, I've set this up so that the units come out right. We've really are working the same 2 problems that we would have worked in the other method, except that we're doing it in one line, in 1 step, and we're making sure that the unit comes out right. grams down here in the denominator will cancel the grams here. So at this point, we have moles per milliliter. And putting milliliters up here, milliliters are going to cancel, and we'll have the units liters. So let's fill in the numbers that we need and then work the problem. Here's what we're given. 1 mole of sodium chloride is the molecular weight in grams. So we'd use the periodic table, look this up, 58.5 grams of sodium chloride. The relationship between liters and milliliters, 1,000 milliliters in every liter. So now we've got it set up so that the unit comes out right. We'd multiply the numerators, divide by the denominators. the answer comes up to be 0.513 moles per liter, or 0.513 m.